Hi students, welcome to my channel. I wish you all the best. So far I have completed 4 chapters. Chapter 1, heat. Chapter 2, acids, bases and salts. Chapter 3, refraction of light at plane surfaces. Chapter 4, refraction of light at curved surfaces. Now the chapter 6th. Structure of atom part 1. I wish you once again welcome to my channel. You like, share and subscribe to my channel. So today's session is structure of atom part 1, multiple choice questions. So once again I wish you all the best. Welcome to my YouTube channel, GD Reddy YouTube channel. So structure of atom part 1, multiple choice questions. Question number 1 on the screen. So an emission spectrum consists of bright spectral lines on dark background. So what is emission spectrum? Ante a spectrum which consists of bright spectral lines on a dark background is nothing but emission spectrum. Which one of the following does not corresponding to the emission spectrum? That is bright spectral lines. So frequency of emitted radiation, wavelength of emitted radiation, energy of emitted radiation and velocity of light. Which one of the following is not corresponding to the bright spectral lines? Tell me. Yeah, very good. You are correct. Answer D, velocity of light. So all these are related to emission spectrum. Emission spectrum. Next, the emission energy is written in terms of E is equal to h nu. E emission energy or absorbed energy. E is equal to h nu. E is equal to h nu. So here nu is equal to c by lambda. Nu is equal to c by lambda. So totally E is equal to, we say, H C by lambda. So here E is the absorbed or emitted energy of emitted radiation in this question. H is the constant known as Planck's constant. Nu is the frequency of emitted radiation. Then as the relation nu is equal to c by lambda, so lambda is the wavelength of emitted radiation. Here c is the velocity, speed, it is constant. So andavalla remaining 3, energy of emitted radiation, option C, lambda, wavelength of emitted radiation, B, nu, frequency of emitted radiation. These 3 are related to the emission spectrum. Next question on the screen. The maximum number of electrons that can be accommodated in the L cell. You know that in atom, the cells are represented by the capital letters K, L, M, N and so on. K is the first cells, L is the second cell, M is the third cell, N is the fourth cell and so on. Then the maximum number of electrons in the given cell is formula 2n square. So what is the formula for maximum number of electrons? 2n square. N is the number of the shell. N is the number of the cell. K shell for K cell, N is equal to 1. For L cell, it is 2. For M cell, it is 3. For N cell, it is 4. So for L cell, N value is 2. So if you substitute 2N square prakaramu, if you substitute 2 into 2 n place lo substitute chesthe entha avutundi 2 square. So 2 square is equal to entha 4. 4 into 2 entha 8. So option C is the correct. Yeah. Next, if L is equal to 1 for an atom, then the number of orbitals in its subshell. You know that L has the values. L is the azimuthal quantum number. It has the values 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on up to n minus 1. Up to any values untai? N minus 1. Maximum number of L value is N minus 1. Least or minimum value of L is 0. So for L is equal to 0, the name of the subshell is S. For 1, it is P. For 2, it is D. For 3, it is F. So given L is equal to 1. So name of the subshell is P. P. Name of the subshell is P. Next, number of orbitals in the given subshell is equal to formula MA 2L plus 1. 2L plus 1. 2L plus 1. So now L is equal to 1, 2 into 1, 2 plus 1 is equal to ento tundi, yeah, 3. So number of orbitals in the given subshell whose L value is 1 is equal to 3 according to 2L plus 1 formula. Next question on the screen, the quantum number which explains about size and energy of the orbit or the cell. Size and energy of the orbit. Yeah, very good. You are correct. Principal quantum number denoted by the letter N. N is the principal quantum number. It explains the size and energy of the orbit. L is the azimuthal quantum number. It explains the shape of the orbital or shape of the subshell. ML, orientation of the orbitals in the space. MS, spin quantum number, spin of the electron, either clockwise or anti-clockwise. Next, speed of light is, simply we can say in vacuum. Tell me, yeah, very good. 3 into 10 power 8 meters per second. Option A, not 3 into 10 power 8 meter second. So option A is correct. Next question on the screen. When electric charge vibrates, so any electric charge vibrates, it produces electromagnetic wave. Next one, the range of wavelengths covering from red color to violet color. So here we say VBG, or you know that there are 7 colors in the rainbow. What are those? Violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red. These are the seven colors consists of in the rainbow. So from red color to violet color, the range of wavelength is called, these all the colors are can be seen by our naked eye. Any colors we can see with our naked eye. Mana kanti tho neruga chudavachu. So hence it is known as visible spectrum. So visible spectrum consists of seven colors, VGR. Next one, you know that UV spectrum, UV rays, these are emitted from the sun. Emitted from the sun, which are not visible. If manu kanti kanipinchu ma, similarly IR rays, IR spectrum, you know that to operate our TV in our home, we have to use our remote. When we press any key on the remote, it produces IR rays. These are not visible to our naked eye. Manam aa kanti tho chudalemma. Remote nokkinappudu IR rays ni velabadte aa rays poyi TV unnatundi button pain padinappudu respond avutundi. So they are not visible to our eye. So next question on the screen, electromagnetic energy can be gained or lost, absorbed or emitted anachu in discrete values. This statement was proposed by, so any electromagnetic energy can be absorbed or emitted, gained or lost in discrete values. This is proposed by Max Planck. So each discrete energy is known as the photon. Next question on the screen, which of the following is a failure of Bohr's atomic model? Failures of Bohr atomic model, tell me, splitting of plane spectra, stationary orbit, emission spectrum, hydrogen spectrum. So he proposed stationary orbits, similarly emission spectrum and hydrogen spectrum. So not related to failure of the Bohr's atomic model. Splitting of line spectra, he could not account for the splitting of line spectra in either magnetic field or electric field. So if the splitting of line spectra is in magnetic field, it is known as Zeeman effect. In electric field, it is known as Stark effect. These two effects are not explained by Bohr's atomic model. Next question, contribution of Sommerfeld to the model of an atom. Model of an atom. He proposed, very good, elliptical orbits. Elliptical orbits. So here, what is meant by model of atom? You know that in atom, electrons, which are negatively charged particles, protons, which are positively charged particles, and neutrons, which are neutral particles, are present in an atom. So arrangement of these three subatomic particles in an atom is known as the model of atom, or otherwise it is known as spectrum, structure of an atom. Next question on the screen. Quantum mechanical model of atom was proposed by, quantum mechanical model, tell me. Irwin Schrodinger, option B is correct. Size and energy of the main cell. Size and energy of the main cell, that is orbit, was given by, very good, principal quantum number, keep it up, you are correct. Next, angular momentum quantum number, it is also represented by N. Angular momentum quantum number, L, it gives the shape of the orbitals. Magnetic quantum number, it gives the orientation of the electron cloud or orbital, known as ML. Spin quantum number, it explains the spin of the electron. Either it is clockwise or an anti-clockwise, MS. Next question, N is equal to 3. The main cell is, already in the previous questions, I say that K is the first cell, L is the second cell, N is the third cell K L M N and so on. So K L M, M is the third cell. M is the third cell. Next, the shape of the particular subcell is known by. So shape of the particular subcell, that is the orbital, is known by knowing azimuthal quantum number L value. L gives the shape of the particular orbital or subcell. Next, if n is equal to 3, the maximum value of L is. So you know that L has the values 0 to n minus 1. L has zeros values from 0 to n minus 1. 0 to up to n minus 1. The maximum value of L is n minus 1. So for n is equal to 3, the maximum value of L is n place to 3, substitute chesthe 3 minus 1. We get 2. So answer option D is correct. The value of L for n is equal to 2. Values of L for n is equal to 2. For a given value of n, n vilva ichinappudu, nth vilva enta unte, L has any same values. So L for a given value of n, L has n values antamma. N yokk ichina viluvaku L viluvalu n viluvalu untayi from 0 to n minus 1. So L has values from 0 to 1, 0 and 1 for n is equal to 2. So n value 2 got L values 2 untayi. Aa 2 values evi ante 0 and 1. Next question on the screen, orientation of the orbital in space. Orientation of the orbital in the space is related to the other orbitals in the term is known by, tell me. Yeah, very good. Magnetic quantum number, orientation antane magnetic quantum number. Shape of the orbital antane angular momentum quantum number. Size and energy antane principal quantum number. Spin of the electron antane electron spin quantum number. Next, for a given value of L, the number of integer values of MLR, for a given value of L, MLR is equal to 2L plus 1, 2L plus 1, it is the number of integer values of ML, magnetic quantum number. Clockwise or anti-clockwise orientation of the electron in an orbital is given by, it is nothing but spin of the electron. Spin may be clockwise or anti-clockwise. Tell me, by MA, spin quantum number. Very good. Which of the following is not correct? Is not correct for a set of quantum number. First one, n is equal to 1, l is equal to 0, ml is equal to 0. It is correct. N is equal to 2, l is equal to 1. It is also correct. So n cannot be 0. N where n has the values from 1 to n. So minimum value for n is equal to 1 and maximum value is equal to n. So n cannot be 0. Number of cells cannot be 0. Number of orbitals anedi 0 kaadu. So it is the wrong answer, wrong statement. Next, when electron moves from higher orbit to lower orbit, when electrons moves from higher orbit to lower orbit, you know that higher orbit has higher energy level, lower orbit has lower energy level. When electron moves from higher energy level to lower energy level, some energy is lost, means emitted. So due to emitted, the spectrum formed is emission spectrum. So electrons from higher energy orbit to lower energy orbit like jump aithe em avutundi, energy anedi emitted avutundi. This emitted energy forms emission spectrum, udgara varnapatanni erparustundi. Next question on the screen, which of the following is the violate of Hund's rule? Violate of Hund's rule. What is Hund's rule? In degenerate orbitals, pairing of electrons takes place in degenerate orbitals. Pairing of electrons takes place only after all the available orbitals have occupied one electron each. So orbitallo mukhyanga degenerate orbitals ante mean samasakti orbitals which have the same energy. ఒక్కొక్క ఆర్బిటాల్లో ఒక్కొక్క ఎలక్ట్రాన్ వచ్చిన తర్వాతనే జత కూడడం జరుగుతుంది. ఇయర్ 2p 2p హ్యాస్ 3 ఆర్బిటల్స్ px py అండ్ pz. ఈచ్ ఆర్బిటల్ గెట్స్ వన్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఈచ్. సో ఇట్ ఈస్ అకార్డింగ్ టు హున్స్ రూల్. నెక్స్ట్ ఆప్షన్ బి ఇయర్ 2p. సో దేర్ ఆర్ 4 ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్, వన్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఈచ్ ఇన్ 2px 2py 2pz, దెన్ ఓన్లీ పేరింగ్ టేక్స్ ప్లేస్. ఇట్ ఈస్ ఆల్సో అకార్డింగ్ టు హున్స్ రూల్. Option C, here 2p, there are 3 electrons. So 3 electrons must occupy 1 electron each among the 2px, 2py, 2pz. So these electrons must be in the 2pz. So it is the violation of Hund's rule. Option C is correct. Next, which of the following is violation of Abbau principle? Abbau principle ఏం చెప్తుంది? ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఆక్యుపై ద ఆర్బిటల్ ఆఫ్ లీస్ట్ ఎనర్జీ. ఆర్బిటల్ ఆఫ్ లీస్ట్ ఎనర్జీ. సో ఇయర్ 1s 2s 2p ఇట్ ఈస్ ద కరెక్ట్ బి ఆప్షన్. 1s ఆఫ్టర్ ఫిల్లింగ్ అప్ ఆఫ్ 1s ఆర్బిటల్ దేర్ ఈస్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఆర్ నాట్ ఎంటర్డ్ ఇన్ టు 2s ఆర్బిటల్ విచ్ గోస్ ఇన్ టు 2p ఆర్బిటల్. Here 2s and 2p, energy of 2s is less than 2p. 2s yokka energy 2p kanna takkuva. So electron must occupy in the 2p orbital before going into the 2p. So hence it is the violation of Abbau principle. Next question on the screen. Among 3s, 3p, 4s and 3d, which one has the lowest energy? How can we find the energy of the given subshell? So n plus l value, n plus l values gives the energy of the subshells. So here l is equal to 0 ithe s orbital, you know that l is equal to 0 1 2 3 and so on and so on. L is equal to 0 aithe it is S subshell, 1 aithe L subshell, 2 aithe P subshell, sorry ma, yes, 1 aithe P subshell, 3s, s is equal to 0. So its n plus l value is 3 అవుతుంది. For 3p, 3 plus 1, 4 అవుతుంది. For 4s, 4 plus 0, it is also 4 అవుతుంది. 3D, 3 plus 2, 5 అవుతుంది. 5 అవుతుంది. Here there is 3P and 4S have same N plus value. Same N plus value. Next, here the question is lowest energy. Lowest energy. 3 is the lowest, then 4 and 5. So 3S is the lowest energy. Yes, which is the correct orbital designation for the electron with the quantum numbers n is equal to 4, l is equal to 3, ml is equal to 2 and ms is equal to 1/2. So l is equal to 3 aithe a orbital lo tell me a subshell lo f. L is equal to 3 aithe it is designated by the f subshell. So 4 is given n value. So the orbital designation is F4F. Very good. Next question on the screen. Magnetic quantum number value for an orbital is given as -1. Therefore, it cannot be. ML, magnetic quantum number ML has the values from minus L to plus L, in total 2L plus 1 value. So for a given value of L, ML values ennu untai ma? ML values ennu untai? 2L plus 1. 2L plus 1. Ave vente 2L plus 1. That is equal to, they are minus L2. Minus L2. To 0 to including 0 plus L varaku untai. So now which one of the following is not given minus 1, cannot be given minus 1. So for S orbital, you know that L value 0, L is equal to 0. S orbital L is equal to 0. According to ML is 2L plus 1. 2 into 0, 0 plus 1. ML has only one value, which is also 0. For this ML value is equal to 0. Ane oka value untundi. So it cannot be minus 1. So option A is correct. Yes, which one of the following is correct with respect to d orbital? With respect to d orbital, edi correct to tell me. So d orbitals, d lo enna mottham enni orbitals untai? 5 d orbitals untai annam. So n cities, 5 fold degenerate orbital. Next question on this, the order of filling up of the electrons in the orbital of an atom will be, tell me, 3d, 4p, 4s. It is wrong. 4p and 4s. 4s is less than 3p. And 3d and what is tappu? 3d, 4s, 4p, 4d tappu. Idu kuda tappu. So idu kuda tappu. So option D is correct. 4s, 3d, 4p and 5s and 4b. It is the order as per Euler diagram or n plus l values. So either Euler diagram or according n plus l values, it is the correct order of filling up of the electrons in the atom. Which one of the following is not correct? Not correct. 2p6, it is correct. In second cell there are p subcell, 2p subcell. It has maximum 6 electron. Then the third cell, there is a s orbital. In second cell, there is no d orbital. In the second cell, that is L cell, only 2 subcells are there. For L subcell, n is equal to 2. L subcell n value ento avutundi? 2 avutundi. Kati 2 subcells maatrame untayi. ఆ 2 సబ్ సెల్స్ ఏవేవి? 2s అండ్ 2p. ఇన్ ద సెకండ్ సెల్ ఓన్లీ 2 సబ్ సెల్స్, 2s అండ్ 2p. దేర్ ఇస్ నో d సబ్ సెల్. హెన్స్ ఆప్షన్ c ఇస్ రాంగ్. ఎలక్ట్రోమాగ్నెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ ఇస్ క్యారెక్టరైజ్డ్ బై, సో ఎలక్ట్రోమాగ్నెటిక్ ఎనర్జీ e ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు, ఆల్రెడీ I explained the previous question, E is equal to H nu. E is equal to H nu. H is the Planck's constant. Nu is the frequency of radiation. That is equal to nu value. Name right chunnamu. C by lambda. C is the speed, velocity of the light or emitted radiation. Lambda is the wavelength. Hence, the electromagnetic energy E is characterized by nu and also lambda. So frequency and wavelength. So option C is correct. Next question, who modified Bohr's theory introducing elliptical orbits? Who introduced elliptical orbit? Tell me. Yeah, very good. Sommerfeld proposed elliptical orbits. Which one of the following electronic configuration corresponds to an inert gas? What are the inert gas? Zero group elements, eta group elements. You know that helium, argon, krypton, xenon, etc. Inert gases are helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, etc. They have 8 electrons in their outermost shell. N electrons untai. 8 electrons in their outermost shell except helium. So here 2s2 2p6 in second cell there is 8 electrons, so it is the inert gas. Next question, according to Abbau principle, electron has the tendency to occupy the orbital which has, so it is the statement of Abbau, lowest energy. Electrons modata lowest energy un orbital ne occupy chestai, akramisthai. So electron has a tendency to occupy the orbital which has lowest energy. Next question on the screen, in which of the following Abbau principle is violated? Electron must occupy lowest energy, then only goes into higher energy level. Tell me, Abbau principle is violated. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p1. It is according to Abbau principle. 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s1. It is also according to Abbau principle. Next, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6, 4s2 and 3d1. It is also according to Abbau principle. So option D is violated because here after completion of 2p orbital, electron must go into 4s orbital because 4s has the energy 4 plus l, s 0 got 4 untundi, 3d 3 plus 2 5 untundi, 3d is higher energy than the 4s anamata. So after completion, after this filling up of 3p subshell, electrons must go into 4s subshell, so it is violated according to Abbau principle. Next one, the magnetic quantum number. Magnetic quantum number. M which not ma. For the outermost electron is so of sodium is, sodium has atomic number 11. Sodium has atomic number 11. You know that. So for outermost electron of sodium, electronic configuration of sodium is 2, 8, 1. So electronic configuration of sodium. Is 2, 8, 1. So the last electron is present in the 3s orbital. 3s orbital. So if you write the electronic configuration sodium, we get 1s2. First cell there is 2 electrons. 2s2. And 3s1. So last outermost electron is present in 3s orbital. For s orbital, you know that L value 0. For s orbital, L is equal to 0. So M magnetic quantum number L value, M value is also 0. Option A is correct. Now the maximum number of electrons that can be accommodated in all the orbitals for which L is equal to 3 is. You know that L is equal to 3. Yes, P, D, L is equal to 3. It is the F subshell. In F sub cell, there are, you know that according to 2L plus 1, according to 2L plus 1, it has 2 into 3 plus 1, 2 into 3 plus 1. So that is equal to ఎంత అవుతుంది 7 అవుతుంది. So 7 orbitals are there in F sub cell. In each orbital there is 2 electrons, total 7 into 2, 14 electrons are present in F sub cell in which L value is 3. Next question on the screen. When the 4p orbital in any atom are filled completely, then the next electron goes to. So after a 4p, the electron enter into, tell me. Yeah, 5s. Yes, 5s according to n plus l values. Then nitrogen atom has 3 unpaired electrons because of నైట్రోజన్ ఆటంలో 3 అన్పేడ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఉంటాయి. ఎందువల్ల? టెల్ మీ. బికాస్ ఆఫ్ హుండ్స్ ప్రిన్సిపల్, విచ్ స్టేట్ దట్ ఇన్ డీజెనరేట్ ఆర్బిటాల్స్ ఈచ్ ఆర్బిటాల్ ఈజ్ సింగ్లీ ఆక్యుపైడ్, దెన్ ఓన్లీ పేరింగ్ టేక్స్ ప్లేస్. హుండ్స్ రూల్ ప్రకారము నైట్రోజన్ ఆటంలో 3 అన్పేడ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఉంటాయి మా. ఆల్ ద 4 క్వాంటమ్ నెంబర్స్ మే నాట్ బి ద సేమ్ ఫార్ ఎనీ 2 ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఇన్ ఎ సింగిల్ ఆర్బిటాల్. దిస్ ఈజ్ నోన్ యాజ్. Tell me. Yeah, very good. Pauli's principle. That is Pauli's principle. All the 4 quantum numbers may not be the same for any 2 electrons in a single atom. So no 2 electrons can have all the 4 quantum numbers same. Statement, you know that. It is the Pauli principle. Next question. The n plus l value for 3D orbital is, you know that for d, l is equal to 2, L is equal to 2, cut 2 plus, sorry, 3 plus 2 is equal to 5, 3 plus, for D, L value is 2, for D, L value 3, 2 plus 2 is equal to 5. Next question on the screen. Maximum number of electrons present in N cell, K, L, M, N. So you know that maximum number of electrons formula I mean 2N square, 2N square, maximum number of electrons present in the given main cell is 2N square. For N cell, KLMN, it is the fourth cell, N is equal to 4. For Nth cell, N principal quantum number value, N is equal to 4. So if you substitute 4 in place of N value, we get 2 into 4 square. 4 square is 16 into 2. And the, yeah, very good. 32. Now splitting of the light into different colors is called splitting of light into different colors. We have already seen in the previous chapter. Different colors here. Light splits into 7 colors known as dispersion. Dispersion of light. Yeah, as waves are produced when an electric charge vibrates. So whenever an electric charge vibrates, electromagnetic waves are produced. Electromagnetic waves are produced. Option C. Then in an electromagnetic wave, electric and magnetic fields are, electromagnetic wave lo both electric and magnetic fields untai. They are vibrating. Everything ఉంటాయి ఆర్ పర్పెండిక్యులర్ టు ఈచ్ అదర్, ఒకదానికొకటి లంబంగా ఉంటాయి. దే ఆర్ పర్పెండిక్యులర్ టు. దెన్ ఆర్బిటాల్ ఆఫ్ లీస్ట్ ఎనర్జీ, ఆర్బిట్ ఆఫ్ లీస్ట్ ఎనర్జీ, మా ఆర్బిట్ ఆఫ్ లీస్ట్ ఎనర్జీ, తక్కువ శక్తి ఉన్న కక్ష, ఆర్బిట్ షెల్ ఏది? ఫస్ట్ సెల్ విచ్ హైస్ నోన్ యాజ్ కే షెల్ ఈస్ ద లీస్ట్ ఎనర్జీ సెల్, లోయెస్ట్ ఎనర్జీ షెల్ ఆర్బిట్. Among 3p, 4s, 3d, 4p orbitals, which has the least energy? We tell the least energy undedi edi, tell me. for 3p, n plus l values as the p orbital ke l value anta 1. 3 plus 1, it has 4. 4 has 4 plus 0, it is also has 4. 3d, 3 plus 2, it has 5. 4p, it is also has 5. So according n plus l values for 3p, n plus 1 is equal to 4. 4 has 4 plus 0, s value, s l value 0 got 4, 3d 5, np ki 4p ki 5. So n plus l values. N plus L values anamata. For 3P it is 4. For 3P ki 4, 4S ku 4, 3D ki 5, 4P ki 5. So both as these two have same value for 3P orbital, N value is least 3. So 3P is the least energy. If any two subshells have same n plus l value, then the subshell with lowest n value is the least energy subshell. So 3 is less than 4, got it? 3p is the least energy. Next one, the subshells present in L cell, KL. It is the second cell. You know that in second cell, there are two subshells, namely S and P. S and P. Next one, the maximum value of L for N is equal to 5. L for N is equal to 5. Know that maximum value of L is N minus 1. Maximum value of N is, L is N minus 1. So 5 minus 1, we get 4 is the option. Yeah, very good. Then F orbitals are present in. F orbitals are present in. Tell me F orbitals, K, L, M and N, N shell. In K shell, there is only S orbital. K shell lo S untundi. L shell lo both S and P. S and P renduntai. M shell lo S, P, D, K, L, M. Third cell gaati, three subcells untai with S, P, D. So then N cell, it has fourth cell, K, L, M, N. Fourth cell got four subcells untai. S, P, D, F. S, P, D, F. So F orbitals are present in F cell. Then the number of values for ML when L is equal to 3. L is equal to 3, it is ML values in one time. Tell me formula, 2L plus 1. 2L plus 1. So L value 3 got given. 2 into 3, 6 plus 1 is equal to, tell me, yeah, 7 values. Then the quantum number which gives shape of the orbital, shapes of the orbital, azimuthal quantum number, which is option C. Next question on the screen. The color of dash color of visible spectrum has highest wavelength. You know that visible spectrum consists of seven colors. VIBGR from VIBGR. V-I-B VIBGR G-Y-O-R. So when we go from violet to red, the wavelength increases. Wavelength increases. So red has the highest wavelength. Red has the highest wavelength. Next question on screen. Strontium chloride produces a dash colored flame. So in flame test, strontium chloride produces, tell me, yeah, crimson red. Crimson red. Green is copper salts, apple green is barium salts. When an electron jumps from higher energy state to higher energy level to lower energy states, so ekku shakti sthayi nundi takku shakti sthayi kosthe emutundi, difference energy is emitted as the emitted రేడియేషన్ సో ఎమిట్స్ ఎనర్జీ ఎక్కువ శక్తి స్థాయి నుండి తక్కువ శక్తి హైయర్ ఎనర్జీ లెవెల్ నుంచి లోయర్ ఎనర్జీ లెవెల్లోకి ఎలక్ట్రాన్ జంప్ అయినప్పుడు ఇట్స్ ఎమిట్స్ ఎనర్జీ నెక్స్ట్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ నాట్ పాసిబుల్ టు ఫైండ్ ద పొజిషన్ అండ్ వెలాసిటీ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ సైమిల్టేనియస్లీ ఎగ్జాక్ట్ పొజిషన్ అండ్ వెలాసిటీ ఆఫ్ ఎన్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్ సైమిల్టేనియస్లీ ఇట్ ఈస్ ప్రపోజ్డ్ బై టెల్ మీ హైజన్బర్గ్ అన్సర్టెనిటీ ప్రిన్సిపల్ ఇట్ ఈస్ హైజన్బర్గ్ అన్సర్టెనిటీ ప్రిన్సిపల్ నెక్స్ట్ క్వాంటమ్ మెకానికల్ మోడల్ ఆఫ్ ఎన్ ఆటమ్ వాజ్ డెవలప్డ్ బై ఆల్రెడీ వచ్చింది ఇర్విన్ స్క్రోడింగర్ ఇర్విన్ స్క్రోడింగర్ నెక్స్ట్ క్వశ్చన్ ఆన్ ద స్క్రీన్ ద రీజన్ ఆఫ్ స్పేస్ అరౌండ్ ద న్యూక్లియస్ వేర్ ద ప్రాబిలిటీ ఆఫ్ ఫైండింగ్ ద ఎలక్ట్రాన్ ఈజ్ ఎన్ మ్యాక్సిమమ్ Tell me the space around the nucleus where the probability of finding the electron is maximum is called an orbital. The name term orbital and term next orbital quantum gives. So orbital quantum number m is tundi. It is nothing but azimuthal quantum number l well l anamata. Azimuthal quantum number also known as orbital quantum number. Shape of the orbital. Shape of the orbital it gives shape of the orbital next question Stark effect of is so there are two effects Stark effect and Geman effect Stark effect is splitting of spectral lines in dash field spectral lines in electric field is Stark effect suppose magnetic field it is Geman effect it is Geman effect it is Geman effect anamata so splitting of spectral lines in electric field is Stark effect in magnetic field is the Geman effect next question is the electron configuration of chromium is so chromium atomic number tell me it is the 24th element so its electronic configuration is tell me yeah very good argon 4s1 and 3d5 argon 4s1 and 3d5 next question noble gases belongs to noble gases known as zero group elements rare gases 8a or zero group 8a or zero group or zero group next question on screen the general electronic configuration noble gases these noble gases ke ka general electronic configuration except helium all have 8 electrons in their valence shell they follow octet rule ns2 np6 so noble gases have 8 electrons in their valence shell except helium it has only 2 electrons it has only duplet ns2 duplet and term 2 electrons though it has even though 2 electrons it has completely valence shell it is placed in the zero group next question the clockwise spin of electron is denoted by so the spin of electron may be either clockwise or anti clockwise anukunnam the clockwise spin is denoted by upward arrow then the anti clockwise is downward arrow radar or dash waves radar waves are microwave then the wavelength of range of visible spectrum is so visible spectrum antane em vibgr violet to red color 7 colors untai each color has its own wavelength so the range of wavelength of visible spectrum is 400 nanometers to 700 nanometers next question as n increases n means principal energy sorry principal quantum number increases size of the orbit is also increases next question sorry today's all the best we have to complete our chapter bits today next tomorrow we can continue from 67th bit okay thank you bye thank you Once again, I wish you all the best. I wish you all the best. Like, share, and subscribe to my channel. You have to watch all my videos. Don't miss. Once again, I wish you all the best.